Thank you for listening to my talk on 3D visualization of tropical cyclone model forecasts and observations. My name is Rachel Zelinsky. I'd like to acknowledge my co-authors, both from NHC and CIRA. This is my postdoc work I did while at CIRA under the Hurricane Supplemental Fund. So jumping right into it, forecasters use 2D fields to examine 3D data, and then they have to attempt to build a mental picture of what that 3D data looks like from those 2D fields. The goal of this work is to improve the real-time assessment of model reliability by NHC forecasters and to facilitate post-storm analysis by creating 3D operational products for the hurricane specialists using observations and model analyses and forecasts. New products should fit into these three categories. First, fit into operations and/or post-analysis work, provide new information or a new way to view data, and be user-friendly. So the tools that we are using to make these new products come from the Python module Plotly, which is an open source graphing library that creates HTML files with interactive 3D visualizations. Pros for developing operational products in this module include it being Python-based. Therefore, you know, it can be automated and scripted. It does not require any specialty software. The scripting and plotting version portion of it is Python, so very easy to use. And the end product, you only need a browser to view the HTML files. And any data that you can read in Python, you can plot in Plotly. So it gives you the potential to display all sorts of data sets. Challenges with this particular module is that it's not designed specifically for atmospheric data. So atmospheric data sets are often very large. Think of the GFS or HWRF. So that can lead to visualizations that make HTML files that are very, very large. And if you have a very large HTML file, it's not going to load in your browser. So here is the 3D visualization homepage where you can look at all the different products. We have two categories, observations and models. We'll start in the observations, and we have here the NOAA flight TDR. And when you go to this page, what you find is this top box has the latest flight. So the most recent flight to have flown was this ADA flight from November. And when flights are ongoing, this will update with whatever that flight is as soon as the data comes in. So you have six different things you can choose from. You have the reflectivity volume, or horizontal slices, or vertical slices, and then you have the same for the wind. So we can look at an example here. We'll click on the composite. So here you're presented with the reflectivity volume over here on the left, and then just a 2D slice of the 0.5 kilometer reflectivity. This provides some reference since we are more used to looking at 2D plots than 3D. But as you can see in the 3D volume, you can turn it to look at it from different angles. You can also see cones, which are the 3D version of wind vectors. You can zoom in and out and investigate any features you find interesting. What you also have on the 3D visualization for the TDR page is this bottom box here, which is the archive flights. So here we can look up any past flights that the tool made visualizations for. So you select the year and the flight. So for instance, we can go all the way back to August, so that this is a LoRa flight. That's it. So yeah, here is this August flight of LoRa. And here we'll look at an example of the wind, but the horizontal slice option. So now your view is a little different. You have the horizontal slices in here. If you press play, you can see each level of the TDR. in the wind. And so you can manipulate this. Say you want to look at it right from the top. You can see how the different levels change. So now if we return back to the homepage, we can look at our next category, which are the models. We have three, the GFS, H4th, and HMOD. So we can start in the GFS. So here you're presented with the selector page, and you can fill out the fields that it's asking for. Then you have the option of doing a box that you center around a particular latitude and longitude, and you get the width. Or you can select the basin and see a basin scale view of the GFS of the time you're interested in. So now you're given your selection page, reminding you of the date, time, and run that you picked. And you are given all of these. So we clicked the products for wind, relative humidity, and vorticity. So what you're given is the wind volume and horizontal slices of that volume, same for relative humidity and absolute vorticity, and then normalized vorticity. You get also, that's where I have the absolute vorticity being normalized by the maximum vorticity at each level. It cleans up the volume a little bit, makes it easier to look at. So if we look, for an example, at the wind volume, here you have Hurricane Laura again at landfall, the wind volume in the GFS. So back at the home page, we have our two regional models, the HWRF or the HMON. These two have the same functionality. The selectors are the same setup, so we'll just look at one. Start with the HWRF. And again, you fill in the fields that you desire to look at. And on your selection page, you're given the products that you made. So again, we can look at the wind volume. And again, we have the wind speed and the cones showing the wind direction for Laura around landfall. And also, something to note is you can download any of these HTML files and view them offline because they are self-contained. So you can save whatever product that you ask the tool to make for you. So a few quick notes about using the web interface. The HTML files are pretty large, so loading times are internet dependent. So you do have to be a little bit patient when you're using this yourself. And also for the model selectors, the more products you pick to generate, the longer the wait is for the scripts to run. So in some cases, it can be up to 90 seconds. So again, you just have to be a little bit patient. So do the new products fit into the three categories that I had listed at the beginning of the presentation? Here are some examples for how they do. I'd like to highlight that during the 2020 season, some of the forecasters were able to use some of the TDR products. They used the horizontal slice tool to identify tilt in Laura before it intensified. And hopefully during the 2021 season, I will have more opportunities to show more of the forecasters these tools. And especially the model products, which they haven't had a chance to use, they can evaluate some of the utility of them. I also have a future wish list for the products listed here, but what I showed in this presentation is most likely what you'll see throughout the 2021 season. Feel free to visit the website yourself and play around with the products. Any feedback you have, you can email me. I look forward to your questions at the live session listed here, and thank you for listening.